Even though we can ask SolidWorks to recognize the physical interaction between objects and make the objects behave as if they were interacting with each other as they do in the real world, specifically through the use of motion studies, motion analysis, and parameters such as friction, elastic properties, and gravity, an easy way to simulate the interaction between gears, threaded components like screws, cams, slots, hinges, and universal joints is to use what are called mechanical mates under the mate option within an assembly file. In this video, we will learn the basics of the gear mechanical mates by using a simple gear assembly. If you want to check out how to use some of the other mechanical mates, like the screw or cam mechanical mate, or even how to use motion analysis within a motion study, make sure to check out the links in the description of this video. The most important concept to understand here is that these mechanical mates are not simulating any type of physical contact or interaction between bodies. They're just a simplified yet clever way of telling SolidWorks that when one of the bodies moves in a certain way, the other body within the same mate should react and move in a particular way. This means that, for example, for gears, when one gear rotates at a particular rate, we can make the quote-unquote connected gear rotate at a rate that follows gear relations in a consistent manner. However, like I just mentioned, SolidWorks is not simulating any type of contact between surfaces. So if you set it up incorrectly, you can make unevenly sized gears rotate at the same rate, and therefore look completely off, since the teeth would be constantly going through each other, mated gears rotate in the same direction, or even have gears that are not physically connected in any way be connected through a mate. So let's take a look at how these mates can be created. First, I'm gonna select two gears that have the same diametral pitch, so that they actually work well together and not have any interference. You should be pretty familiar with diametral pitch, number of teeth, pitch diameter, face, and other terms relating to gear parameters, but if you're not, you can check out this 10-minute Gears Basics lecture video to understand all of the terms that we'll be using in this SolidWorks lesson. Let's say I'm gonna choose two spur gears from Mechmaster that have a 14.5 degree pressure angle, a diametral pitch of 10 teeth per inch, and I'm gonna download the SolidWorks file for one with 18 teeth and another one with 60 teeth. The pitch diameter of these two gears will of course be the number of teeth over the diametral pitch, meaning 1.8 inches for the smaller gear or pinion, and 6 inches for the larger gear. This is important because since the gears have to be placed somewhere in space, we will be creating shafts and a simple support to properly assemble this easy gear system. Since the diameters are 1.8 and 6, the radii are 0.9 and 3 inches. This means that the shafts will have to be located 3.9 inches apart. If we look at the information of the gears I selected, we see that the shaft for the first gear needs to have a diameter of 3/4 of an inch, and that the shaft for the second gear needs to have a diameter of 7/8 of an inch. Additionally, I chose gears that are to have a key between them and the shaft, so that the shaft itself should have a similar keyway, meaning a rectangular slot in which the key goes. To simplify the creation of the assembly in SolidWorks, though, we will just make a shaft that has a rectangular protrusion on its cylindrical surface. The dimensions of these protrusions will be given by the key size that these gears have, and this we can look up through Mechmaster. The keyway's width is 0.188 inches, and the keyway's depth is half of that at 0.094 inches. Now, I won't go into the details of the bearings in this video, because it's way off point. But of course, the shafts would be placed onto some supports, and for the shafts to rotate freely, with as little friction as possible, they would be, for example, press-fitted into, let's say, ball bearings. For this simplified example, we'll just create a circular hole in the supporting structure and create a concentric mate for the shaft to freely rotate. Now let's create these parts. We'll make a simple base that has two half-inch holes 3.9 inches apart. Remember that that was the distance between the centers of the gears, or what is the same, the sum of the two gear radii? We'll give the base a height of 0.3 inches, just to have a certain depth for the shafts to go into. We'll now make the shaft for the smaller gear, which has to be 0.75 inches in diameter, and we'll add a rectangular protrusion to it that has dimensions of 188 and 94 thousandths of an inch for what the keyway and key would be on the shaft. Of course, the keyway and key would not extend along the entire shaft in the real world, but let's assume it does and make it, let's say, 4 inches long, just to be able to fit the gears with their bases and have a bit of a section of the shaft be free. To this, we add an axial circular protrusion half an inch in diameter and 0.3 inches deep so that this goes into the holes we created in our base part. For the second shaft, we'll do the same, this time with a diameter of 0.875 or 7/8 of an inch, same protrusion for the key with the same dimensions, and also the same length for the shaft and same circular protrusion to fit into the hole in the base. Now we go to the base again and use the create assembly from part option. We bring in the base, we bring in the two shafts, and we bring in the two gears. We create simple mates for putting the shafts inside the holes of the base, the end of the shaft to match the base component, and we place the two gears on the shafts facing in the same direction, aligned with each other, the keyways to match with the protrusion of the shafts, and at a distance from the base that allows us to see them around halfway along the shaft. Here you can notice what I was referring to before. SolidWorks will not just identify that there are bodies in contact and automatically make the gears work. One gear can move, and the other one will just stay still, even if the teeth of the first are going through the teeth of the second. And here's how we use the mechanical mates. We go to Mate, then on the left pane we select the Mechanical tab, and after clicking on the gear icon, we select the objects we want to mate. You can select any circular feature from the gears, for example, the external cylindrical surface. You'll notice that the ratio option appears just underneath the gear icon. This is the most important parameter that you need to set, since from the Gear Basics main video you know that the rotation speed ratio is the same as the ratio between diameters or the ratio between teeth, and we know that the first gear has 18 teeth and the second one 60, we can write the ratio as 18 to 60. Just make sure that the numbers do correspond with the correct gear. You'll see little floating frames connected to the gears when you do this. This will tell SolidWorks how much the second gear moves when the first one is moved. For example, we can move the one on the bottom, and the one on top will move at the correct corresponding rate. Notice that there is a reverse option under the ratio values. This is for when you want both selected parts to rotate in the same direction, clockwise or counterclockwise. This would of course be really helpful for setting the relation between two pulleys connected by a belt, for example. Now, one thing that will most likely happen is that the teeth look like they are not 100% aligned, and therefore the interaction looks off. To fix this, we temporarily suppress the mate to align them by moving one of the gears and add the mate again. We do this by right-clicking on the mate, clicking on the suppress icon, manually moving the gear that is driving the other for its tooth to make contact with the tooth of the second gear, and right-clicking on the gear mate again, and this time choosing unsuppress. This way we have a gear system that works like it should. Notice, for example, that for a full rotation of the larger gear, the smaller gear will have rotated 60 over 18, or 3.33 times. To finish up this explanation, let's recall what I mentioned towards the beginning of this video. Since SolidWorks is not really calculating any interaction, we can, for example, change the mate that located the gears next to each other. So now, even when the gears are not touching each other, they still rotate at the correct speed ratio. This can be used when you want two components to act and react correspondingly, let's say inside a speed reducer box that you're not showing the components of. Similarly, you can have the gears located next to each other, but have the wrong ratio. This would of course result in an animation that would be impossible to see in the real world. So again, make sure that you set the mate correctly. This concludes this basic tutorial on how to use the mechanical gear mate. Like I mentioned earlier, if you want to learn the basics of the other types of mechanical mates, such as screws and cams, make sure to check out the links found in the description of this video. Make sure to check all the links in there, since you'll find 10-minute lectures for other SolidWorks topics, as well as other engineering courses such as machine design, mechanics of materials, statics, etc. Thanks for watching!